Kevin Blanco received a life-saving transplant 17 years ago. He got a new kidney when his own stopped working and a donor organ became available. But the transplant itself is not enough. Kevin also needs to take medicine to make sure his body doesn't reject the donor kidney.
I've gone for 5 months now without being able to buy my medicine. That means that I could die at any time.
According to the non-profit health organization Codevida, there is a critical lack of medications to treat transplant patients in Venezuela, putting the lives of more than 3,500 people at risk, and that's prompting patients to take extreme measures to obtain the drugs they need to survive.
The few medicines that I can find now are recycled from a relative of a patient who managed to travel and buy them abroad. But when they came back, it was too late. The patient had died already. I'm using a medicine that could have saved the life of another person, but is now saving mine.
Patients have taken to the streets to protest and assert their right to health care, calling on the government to accept humanitarian aid to help alleviate the internal crisis.
There is an 85% lack of medicines in the pharmacies in Venezuela, and for the few that are available, the price is so high that patients cannot afford them.
The situation went viral on social media last month when Codevida tweeted a desperate plea from a kidney transplant patient searching for the drug she said she had not been able to find for 90 days. She reportedly died hours later.
We have had the problem of dependence on imported products from abroad, and we're suffering from a terrible sabotage this year with the sanctions of the U.S. It's hard, but they are not going to stop us.
President Nicolas Maduro has blamed Venezuela's shortage of medicine on an international conspiracy, on organized crime in Colombia, and on U.S. sanctions. Maduro says he's looking to China and India for help, and he says he's working on a plan for Venezuela to produce its own medicines.
Transplant patients can hear the clock ticking as weeks go by with no medicine. To them, it doesn't matter where the medicine comes from, as long as it reaches them in time. Juan Carlos Lamas, CGTN Caracas.